In this video, I'm going to show you how to install a free SSL certificate on your WordPress site. I'm going to show you two different ways to do this, depending on which hosting company you use. What's happening, everyone? My name is Greg Kononenko. You might also know me as the Caffeinated Blogger. And on this YouTube channel, I publish regular tutorials dedicated to traffic generation, blogging, affiliate marketing, and making money online. Click the subscribe button just below this video and click the bell notification icon. And this way you will get an instant notification next time I upload my next video. Let's get into it. First of all, let's talk quickly why you actually need an SSL certificate. So the first time back in 2014, Google on their official security blog said that for now, they're starting to use HTTPS as a ranking signal in 2014. Back then, it was a very lightweight signal affecting fewer than 1% of global queries, okay? Then they posted an update in February 2018, and they said that for the past several years, we've moved towards a more secure web by strongly advocating the sites that adopt HTTPS encryption. So once again, they've confirmed twice that if you have HTTPS or a security SSL security certificate on your website, then you're very likely going to get more traffic from Google. So very, very important. If you don't currently have an SSL certificate, you should definitely go ahead and install one. So let's talk about the first method. Method one is going to be useful for you if your hosting supports what's called Let's Encrypt. I'm going to show you everything step by step. I'm going to show you how to find out if your hosting actually supports the Let's Encrypt free SSL certificates. And just in case it doesn't, then I've actually got a second method right here in this video that you can use as well. So here are a couple of ways that you can check whether your hosting actually supports free SSL certificate from Let's Encrypt or not. Firstly, you can type into Google what hosting supports Let's Encrypt, and the first result that will come up, just open that up and you will see a list of hosting companies. There are two lists, this first list and then the second list, and check if your hosting company is there or not. I use Siteground. I really highly rate Siteground as a hosting company. I think they're awesome. And Siteground is one of the supported companies under Let's Encrypt. There are a lot of other famous companies, you know, common companies that support Let's Encrypt as well. The second way that you can actually check is you can log into your account, into a hosting account, and then you can check from there. I'm now inside my Siteground account and I'm going to log into my cPanel and I will show you how to check that in cPanel. So I'm inside my cPanel now, and generally if you scroll under security or a similar tab in your cPanel, depending which version your host uses, you will see something called Let's Encrypt, okay? So this is, if you see this Let's Encrypt under security somewhere, or you can even just press Control F and start typing it L-E-T, and it might come up somewhere on the page if you have a lot of different options and different icons. That means that your company actually supports Let's Encrypt and you can use this method. So let me show you step by step how to do this using Let's Encrypt built into your web host. Now, just in case you do not have this Let's Encrypt, just scroll a little bit further in this video and I will show you a second method, right, of how to install free SSL certificate even if your hosting does not support Let's Encrypt. Okay, so let's do this based on the example of my website Travel Croc, on which I want to install an SSL certificate. So the first step will of course be to click onto Let's Encrypt in your cPanel. Then scroll down until you see something that says install new Let's Encrypt certificate, and then choose your domain from the list. So I've now got travelcroc.com selected and I want to choose the SSL type Let's Encrypt SSL. Don't go for the wildcard, just the top one is fine, and click install. Then you will see a success message saying successfully installed SSL, Let's Encrypt certificate added successfully to the installation queue. Just click OK. To check the progress of your installation, here is what you can do. Just go into your domain and type in HTTPS, then a semicolon and two slashes, and type in enter. Okay, if you see that now your domain loads without any issues via HTTPS, that means that your certificate has actually issued. Generally with Siteground, it only takes 1 or 2 minutes. So as you can see, I've only just done this. And now when I come to my website, HTTPS certificate actually loads fine. Before the installation of the SSL certificate, if I did this, if I typed in HTTPS in front of the domain name, then I would have got an error saying there is no valid security certificate. So however, you can still see that there is this little eye icon, if I click on that, it says your connection to this site is not fully secure. So this is because these images are still stored on the non-SSL, the non-secure version of the website. But there is a very easy fix for that as well. You will need this plugin called Really Simple SSL. So you need to make sure that you don't forget to install Really Simple SSL. I'm going to show you how to do that right now. Log into your WordPress admin panel and then type in to search plugins, type in Really Simple SSL and hit search. Take this first plugin that comes up. You can see it's got over a million active installations with a 5-star rating. All you need to do is click install. And once it's installed, you will need to click activate. So now you can see I've got the activate option, which I'm going to click. Then you will see this message, almost ready to migrate to SSL. You will just need to click go ahead, activate SSL, and the plugin will do what it needs to do. After you activate it, when you try to go to another page on your website, you will notice that you will get this error message forcing you to log back in. That is now because the plugin is forcing your website to load over HTTPS, and this is treated as a different login session by your browser. So you will need to log back into your website once again. Now I've logged back in. As you can see, everything is working great. I've now got that little icon. If I come back to the homepage of my website and reload it, you can see that I've now got the icon. So our free Let's Encrypt SSL certificate is now activated and is working great. We're now done with the first method. If you're not sure which hosting you should use, then once again, I recommend Siteground. They're very fast and the support is great. And they also have this free SSL certificate through Let's Encrypt as well. You can check the link in the description below to get the link to get Siteground hosting. But now let's talk about method number two. What if your hosting does not support Let's Encrypt SSL? Don't worry, there is still a very easy way to set up free SSL even if your hosting does not support the Let's Encrypt certificate. I'm going to show you everything step by step. So for the purposes of this demo, I've taken the SSL certificate off from my Travel Croc website. You can see now it's loading as not secure. And if I type in HTTPS in front of it, once again, it will actually not load. It will give me this error message saying that the requested page cannot be found. So for this method, we're going to use CloudFlare. CloudFlare actually has a free SSL certificate function, and it can help you in other ways as well. I run my high traffic websites through CloudFlare because it allows you to speed up your website by loading your website simultaneously through various servers around the world. It's actually really easy to set up and it's completely free. So you can just use the free plan, and the free plan of CloudFlare comes also with free SSL. So let me show you how to do this. So first of all, you will need to register an account on CloudFlare if you don't have one yet. And after you register the account, then log into it. So I'm just going to log in because I already have an existing account with CloudFlare. You will want to then click this button called add a site and type in the name of your website. So here I'm just going to type in travelcroc.com. You don't need to put www or HTTP at the front, just the actual name of your domain. Let's go ahead and click add site now. So then you will see this message saying they're going to query your DNS records. So click next. You will then need to select a plan. So just go ahead and choose a free plan and hit confirm. So you will need to confirm one free website. It will now display some of the DNS checks. You don't need to change anything on this page. Simply come down to this continue button and click continue. Now you will see that CloudFlare is asking to change the name servers from the existing name servers to these CloudFlare name servers. Now this might sound a little bit technical. Don't worry, I'm going to show you everything step by step. So you do this inside the same service where you bought your domain. So for example, if you bought your domain through Namecheap, then you will need to do this inside Namecheap. If you bought your domain through your hosting, for example, if you bought your domain through Siteground, you would do it in Siteground. If you bought it through GoDaddy, then you would need to do it inside GoDaddy, okay? Now, I buy all of my domains inside Namecheap, so I'm going to log into my Namecheap account, and I'm going to show you how to change it inside Namecheap. So inside Namecheap account, simply type in your domain and choose Manage. You will see something here called Name Servers. So you will need to change these to Name Servers to this CloudFlare name service. So the first one, I'm going to copy that and paste it in here. And then I'm going to copy the second one and paste that inside here. And then I need to hit save. And now it's all done and saved. Okay, now we can come back here into, let's just wait until this finishes loading. You can see now the success message, DNS server update may take up to 48 hours. So everything is now saved. So just to clarify, if you're not entirely sure where you need to do this, then try to think, where did you actually buy the domain name? You can search your email for it. And if you did not do this through Namecheap like I did, if for example, you bought your domain through another service, then go to that service and submit a ticket to them and ask them to do this for you. They generally will be more than happy to do this for you. They can update your DNS name records to these ones that Cloudflare has given you. You can also Google. So if you can, you can type in something like how to update name servers on GoDaddy, how to update name servers on Bluehost, etc. And Google instructions will generally tell you how to do that as well. So now come back to Cloudflare and click continue. You will see this page that says complete your name server setup. Travelcrog.com is not yet active on Cloudflare. That's fine. So we've already done this. So all you need to do is just recheck now, and you will see that it's now queued up to be rechecked. And shortly, generally within probably an hour or so, these DNS records will get updated. It might take up to 24 hours for that to happen. You don't need to do anything. Your website is not going to be down in any way. This transition is completely seamless, so don't worry, you can go ahead and do that. It's been about 2 minutes. I've actually just refreshed this page and you can see that now it says, great news, Cloudflare is now protecting your site. So it did not take long at all. So now what you will want to do once this has happened, you will want to come down to this tab here called security, and it says encrypt traffic to and from your website SSL settings. So let's click that. What you will want to do now is on this page, make sure that this setting is set to flexible. There are a few different options. Flexible is the best one for you. Without kind of getting too technical, just wanted to make sure that you know that this is the one that you want. So now let's go back to my website and see if it's now loading fine via HTTPS. So I'm now back here on my website. Let's type in HTTPS and see what happens. So the page actually loads fine without any problems via HTTPS. I just once again now am getting these warnings about mixed content. This happens because all of these images are actually in the background stored on the HTTP version of the website. So I actually need to install a special plugin that will help solve this problem. Once you're inside your WordPress admin, click on Add New under the plugins section, and then search plugins for Really Simple SSL and install this first result, Really Simple SSL. Click Install Now. And then once it's installed, click Activate. The plugin is now activated. So now let's go back to that page and double check and make sure that the error message has actually disappeared. So we're back here. Let's click this reload. And now you can see that we've got the full icon and there is no more error message and everything is actually working great. So once again, just to recap what you need to do, you need to wait until your domain is activated in Cloudflare. It might take up to 24 hours, but don't worry, your site will not be down during this period. You just need to wait until those name service changes actually go through. Generally happens within a few minutes. Now, after that, you will need to type in HTTPS and then your site name, and just make sure that your site is actually loading via HTTPS. All right, that's the next step. Once this is happening, then go to your website, log into admin, and then install and activate the Really Simple SSL plugin. Like I was mentioning to you guys before, Cloudflare actually has got an added benefit. It's completely free and it will also make your site load faster as well, which is very important for Google rankings these days. Plus, of course, it will give you that free SSL certificate, which means that you will get even higher Google rankings as well. If you want to get my free blogging training, then check the link in the description below. There is a free masterclass and a free course that you can sign up for to find out how to build a blog and how to get traffic to the blog in any niche. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this video. My name is Greg Kononenko. On this YouTube channel, I publish regular tutorials dedicated to blogging, traffic generation, affiliate marketing, and making money online. Click subscribe just below this video and tick the little bell notification icon to make sure that you don't miss any of my future tutorials. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you in the next video.